dog does pee in there. Shelter, so it's like, you ever watch Naked and Afraid?
It's kind of like that, but they only have to go like, what, 21 days?
What are they giving them to? Do they give them knives and
I think they
fire?
Get their choice.
Lighters?
They get their choice of stuff. But obviously they're by themselves, they don't have a partner, and they have to get their food on their own. But one of the biggest reasons that they get taken off is because they lose too much weight.
So, by themselves.
They win like.
That's
prizes.
Hard, man.
The prize is $500,000.
If they make it?
Yeah, if they win.
Oh, well, alone, huh? Yeah, that would be scary. Bears.
Yeah.
Bears and hunting. Those Naked and Afraid people are nuts out there with no clothes on. And the Fair Delance. The Fair Delance snakes. That one producer got bit.
I didn't see that.
Oh my god.
Really?
Yeah. He almost lost his foot.
It swelled up.
Well, I mean, if you don't get to the hospital right away, you're dead. No, I mean, it was like Kenny's hand. Except it was on its foot. It was a lesion that was that and 4-inch wide opening on the top of his foot.
It's a big snake?
Doesn't matter how big it is. It's that poisonous. If you get bit, it kills the skin. The skin starts dying.
Look at the bees and that butterfly in that bush right there. They're all sitting down right now.
I got 3 apple juice.
I don't know where his, I ordered his insured like at least almost a week ago. I don't know why it's not here. Are we sure it didn't get sent to somebody else?
Like somebody else's room?
Yeah.
I'm sure.
I ordered 3 cases of 24 and it's not in his fridge. I'm going to have to check and see where it's at.
Hi, Ken. He got a burger.
He needs his protein shakes. I mean, that's all that's keeping him going here. His fridge is empty.
Can't you check online right now?
Yeah. Well, no, I don't know how to log in, but where's Patty here to keep it full? Oh, my phone's working. Call Patty. Start look on Sam's Club account and see if that insurer got shipped to Dad. Number? Bad boy.
Not rich boy.
Of course it did. False man. I got my poles. I'm going to go hit. Well, I bet you there's not even any water over here on this shoreline. You can get through that pole and it's jumping up and down. That's going to be a horrible video.
Thank you. You want to check on me? You want to
eat the whole thing? Yeah.
You're going to call.
It's a bouncy chair, that's why. I just made me French toast about an hour ago, but I could eat. Wally had a big something around it.
Oh my god, it was the best egg sandwich I've ever had in my life.
Who made it?
It was absolutely perfect.
Amy? Boiled over there with Amy cooking all the time. Kind of like Marlo. Eddie's pretty good too.
Thanks, honey.
Yep, me and Wally were out fishing 2 weeks ago. We came here to see you at 8 in the morning, but you were in bed. You opened your eyes couple times and stayed an hour. I had McDonald's sausage muffins for you, but you didn't get out of bed. And then we went fishing for an hour. I caught a bass, Wally caught a northern. He got his northern right out there. Yep. Beautiful morning it was. 2 weeks ago today, actually. Then I got busy at work again and did a bunch of landscaping in the yard. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we tore up when I came to the turkey. Oh yeah, let me call somebody.
No, I'm 6'2".
5'1". Here, get rid of that napkin. You don't need that. I'll save that for later.
Get that wrapper, too.
Are you at home? Can you log into the Sam's Club account and see where Dad's insure is that I ordered a week ago and why it's not here? I ordered it. My phone is videotaping me right now, hooked to a tripod.
You can use mine.
What? We're sitting with my dad. Yeah, it is. But I ordered it from the Maplewood store. You guys' home store is, but it should still show up as a current order. Just see where the hell it is. should be logged in. It pops up automatically. Google password. If you just put the cursor in the box. Cases of 24 of milk chocolate and sure protein shakes. He's wasting away over here. Thank God he's eating his burger. We track the shipment. Oh, it's coming today then? Tuesday, August 24th. It might be dead by then. Gotta get something in them. Okay, thank you. Bye. What's today? The 22nd.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you won't have any protein shakes till Tuesday. 2 days. I need to go to the store and get some and bring them back. That's what I'll do.
What'd they say? 2 days?
Tuesday. Estimated delivery Tuesday. It's all right. We're getting protein into them right now.
Yeah.
They got you in the right field or what? How's that leg?
It's good now, but it's not as strong as it was. You gotta come back a little bit. It doesn't hurt anymore.
You don't work out, do you?
I just do push-ups. That's all I do. I'm gonna start again because my back doesn't hurt anymore since I've been doing the teeter hang-up.
Oh, yeah. You bought one? At yeah. Costco?
Yeah. Online. No, I play anywhere in the outfield. I'm hoping I get to pitch today. I've been pitching more.
You can. Doesn't your shoulder get sore after about 10 throws? It's a fast pitch, right?
No, it's like I've been playing so much and throwing so much, it's just like anything. It doesn't, after a while, it doesn't hurt anymore.
You got any games scheduled for down at the Saints thing?
No, last year was it.
Just that one game, huh?
The team we played there, that's who we played yesterday in a playoff game, and we lost by 2 runs. Well, we should have won that game. We beat them. Okay. Well, two of my teams are done for the year. I got one left. Down by Josh. Tried to get Josh to show up real quick. Meet some guys. Yeah, he's eating that hamburger.
Yeah. It'd be amazing if we could get him to eat the second one. Yeah, we tried to get him in his wheelchair. He's refusing. And that's good, because then he just won't be able to move at all. And he knows that. He's smart. He just can't get out of his mouth what he wants to say. Which would be really upsetting to anybody, obviously. Right, Dad? The best part of the whole place right here.
I think you need to get a different lawnmower.
What's going on with that?
It's too heavy.
It's self-propelled though.
It doesn't matter.
How does she get it up the stairs?
Turning corners.
She wants to breed that. She wants to breed that figgy so bad, you know. But she just can't physically get down and up to take care of the little ones.
The what?
She wants to breed figgy. Where's that?
Yesterday at the thrashing show.
Oh man. She's a ham. Is that Brittany holding Jack?
Yeah. Brandy. And that's Brandy's grandma.
Who's Brandy?
Josh's girlfriend.
Oh. Seems like I would have recognized her, but she's looking away.
Yeah.
And she's got her hair pulled up. Does she normally wear her hair like that?
Yeah.
How's Brandon doing?
Good. He's busy. Thank you.
guy was nuts when I asked him who Brandy was. Josh's girlfriend.
Yeah, they did that. They did the phone ride.
Pony ride. Ready for that burger?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's eating them up.
Pony ride. You better open that bag up and eat it. Well, here, have some juice. Want me to get you a cup? You want a cup? Yeah? Yeah?
No.
No? No? That's not pop, that's apple juice. It's apple juice. Drink every time I'm here, but they normally give it to you in a cup. You want me to get a cup? Can you leave that off?
There's a rock in there.
Slam it at the end.
Yeah, pretty much.
I was watching the video back, and I commented on it. I'm like, that explains why I slammed my drink after my meal. Yeah, because no, that's exactly, he does not drink until he's done eating. It's in the genes, man. And he'll slam two of them.
Yeah.
here last week?
I've been here since me and you were here.
Yeah.
How's that?
Heading here, right about 694-94, one of the billboards said right lane closed, grass fire on the right shoulder. But the fire trucks were just getting done with that one. It was maybe 200 yard stretch, all burnt. They had just put it out. Three more sections of fires going to the west, almost like either the first one to the west started and it was blowing stuff that way, or somebody pulled over and started four or five different fires.
Do you want to sit here, or do you want to wheel down by the lake?
With the wind, I could see it kind of jumping, it's so dry.
Yeah, but why would it
go that way?
Why would it leave a bare spot for 400 yards in between the fire? I guess, yeah.
Yeah, the boundary waters are shut down right now.
What's that?
Wow.
What's more? Oh. You'll piss your pants? Are you sure you don't want no more?
You know I'm good.
You're good?
I think it's good.
You guys are fun.
We're what?
You guys are fun to have. Be around.
Yeah? That's great. I hope the camera got that. What kind of tree is that?
It's a crab.
Yeah, crab apple.
Yep. I think I have one just like it. Three of them in my backyard look like that. What do they call them? Pink? Because the blooms are pink.
It's out in the sun.
It does.
What else? Got 15 yards of mulch delivered. Probably used half of it on my 600 square foot thing around the cul-de-sac on my five magnolias. Now we're going to cut those trees I had stated in the big ones. They're, 90 inch spade. So in my fabric, I got this landscape fabric, it's woven. So when you cut it, it unravels like a blue tarp. You know when the strands start coming off of them when they get old? So you gotta hem all the edges and pin them. So I gotta make some proper.
Your landscape fabric?
Yeah.
It doesn't let weeds through?
Right. Yeah, and then.
Where'd you get it from?
You can get it on Amazon.
It's good stuff.
I Googled, you know, and I found a YouTube video. Well, you know that cheesy stuff they sell at Menards and Home Depot. I'm like, this is a lot of work. I'm not putting this stuff down here. I took it all back. And I found a YouTube video, and he was using that stuff, and they just happened to have it at the MYP landscape place on 36 in DeMontreville there. So I went over there. It's a 6 foot by 300 foot roll, actually a 250 foot roll. But I'd seen it on Amazon, a 300 foot roll, 5 mil for like 150 bucks. I don't think that roll that I bought is going to finish all my trees. So what I'm going to do is dig down around all my big trees, because I mulched them when we planted them in April, and now it's already got grass growing. So I'm going to make a pattern so I can cut a half a circle, about 6 foot. You know, I'll cut a bunch of half circles and pin them around all my trees. I'm going to dig it down about 3 inches so the mower doesn't catch the mulch.
Instead of using edging.
Yeah.
I don't like it.
I don't either. We did edging out there.
It just comes up.
I ran my knife through about 20 feet of it. I had to cut up another piece and go get some stainless steel screws and screw it on there where I cut it. Right after Marcus, who did landscaping for 4 years, he's like, don't do that. You're going to cut the edging. And I'm like, just watch. Like, I'm smarter than him, right? I ran my knife through it for about 20 feet. Horrible, horrible.
Yeah, but the frost pushes it out of the ground anyway.
Yeah, so
I don't like
and the pins, too, that are holding down all the fabric, that those are going to get pushed out. Yeah, landscaping is just something that needs to be done all the time, and it's a horrible job. Yeah. The weeds, man. But so then now, seeing as I YouTube landscape fabric, this video popped up.
And it lets water through it.
Huh?
But it does let the water through it.
Right? Oh, yeah. Yeah, after we got it all done, I took it over to the hose and made a little bucket out of it. I'm like, well, the water better go through here. We just spent 3 days putting this down. And yeah, it runs right through. It's got felt on the bottom.
Well, you gotta let me know how it works.
Well, I know it works great because I was on YouTube searching that. Another video popped up for me. This lady who grows flowers and vegetables up in Canada did a video on that exact fabric. And she's like, yeah, it's great. And she was telling about the pros and cons of it. I mean, YouTube's a go-to for everything.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if I hadn't have done that, we would have probably put down that fabric from Home Depot. Yeah. Which, you know, the only thing I don't like about it is the unraveling. And having to hem it and pin it. And then, whatever you do, don't try and put those pins in the ground with your palm. Because Marcus said, no, I ain't doing that. You know, he knows. And then my hand was sore. Actually, it's better now. You just can't do that. And my hands are cramping up because you're holding the pins to keep them from bending when you're hitting them with a little sledge. Because when it's hemmed over, it's hard to push the pins through.
You hem in the side of it? Where you dig down in the side or straight down on the top?
Just straight down on the top. So anyway, this lady made a pattern out of a 4x8 board with her holes for her vegetables every so often, and then she had a torch that she put on a real low setting and just pushed it through her pattern, and it burns the edges, so it melts it so it doesn't unravel. But how do you do that on a long straight edge?
I think you just run your torch down the edge.
Yeah?
Melted.
Maybe. Patty's off planting flowers through it right now, because I did around the fire hydrant out there. That was a mess.
I heard somebody using it in their vegetable garden to keep the weeds out of it. It keeps the water in, for one thing, and then it doesn't let the weeds in.
So here's what happened at her place. She was talking about the cons, too. Her flowers that were growing all into each other, she said it's a perfect breeding ground because it's too moist underneath the fabric for certain kinds of things, and the flowers were getting diseased because it was too moist.
Fungus.
Yeah. So that was a great video. Just to see all, you know, YouTube is such a great tool. No matter what I do or have done, even if I've done it 100 times, because you forget, you go back and you tune up and you weed out the horrible videos and find one that really makes sense.
Or they come out with new products.
Right. Some guy was bashing me, one of my heating videos on YouTube this morning. Some people got nothing better to do than just, God, what are you doing? Why are you that bored that you have to just sit there? And, wow.
What, rip on you?
Rip on, yeah, that's their job in life, is to sit there and make stupid comments on other people's YouTube videos.
Videos for Etsy. Like yeah. What? How to's or what?
Well, go on my YouTube and look at it. There's a million different, it's just my name, Edward Pelto. There's installation videos, there's service videos. Most of them are bulldog videos that I uploaded off of YouTube years ago, but I got almost 600 subscribers now. Once I get to 1,000, then I'll have to start hitting it harder, because then you can start getting paid. You have to have 1,000 subscribers. Probably been 10 years I've had that channel going. There's videos of me and you surfing on there. I mean everything. My fish aquarium.
Yeah, I remember that. I just didn't know you did any for.
Oh yeah.
For Dead Sea.
Yeah. Yeah, I was trying, and it's amazing to me which ones get the most views. It's not the installation ones that I've done so many videos on. You know.
Yeah.
It's the ones that people want to do themselves, the DIYers.
Right. Guess that's what I mean, the how-to video.
Yeah, yeah. Well, nobody cares about the installation videos, but you know which ones get thousands of hits? Garage heater installs.
Oh, of course. That's what that is. Somebody wants to check that.
Yeah.
You better make sure you got the good info on there.
What else? Yeah, that Patterson AC one, where I've got in-depth soldering tutorials.
Yeah, that's what I mean, the how-tos. Everybody wants to know how to.
Yeah, well, it takes a lot of time to do those videos.
And, I could imagine.
And most of the time, and then people come back like, that joint is cooked, man.
Well, yeah, of course.
I was at the neighbor's house. It was during COVID. We went last spring and hooked up the neighbor's AC where we had done his furnace and air in the middle of winter last year. And then we went back in the spring to set the air, and I got a real good video of Corey soldering and me instructing him on how to move the heat and this and that. That got a lot of videos. And that's the one the guy commented on this morning.
Those are when I want to learn how to weld different joints, I always testify to it too. Some guys are really good at the videos. Give you the info that you really want. The technical details.
It takes a lot. Well, no, because they've got so many views, they pop right up for you. And that's why they've got so many subscribers and so many views. Because it's a good, informative video. I watch these other people, Jake and Nicole, off-grid. Have I ever told you about them? They're up in Canada living on Vancouver Island. They got 20 acres in the middle of a rainforest. They get something like 300 feet of rain a year, but they...
300 feet?
Yeah.
No.
I just watched it like they were the
300
last...
300 inches? 300 feet?
300 feet. That can't be right. I don't know.
Living off the grid.
I think they're going to have a baby now. They've been there 3 years. their videos are just so, and they've got a Patreon channel, and somebody did a video on, well, how much money do Jake and Nicole make off their YouTube videos? And this guy thinks they make, he was doing all the stats and whatnot, $50,000 a month. It's a great channel, dude. I just love watching them. Their videos are so quality. They started out with one boat, like a blow-up with a little tiller motor. I mean, they're out there in the middle of nowhere on the West Coast, up in Vancouver Island, right there where the United States meets Canada. And she cut her leg with a chainsaw once. There's no hospitals there. They had to go to the mainland. I think she's pregnant now, though. But they got two dogs, Kai, and I can't remember the other one. Grizzly bears. Okay, I never told you what they're living in. They built a yurt.
Yeah, I know what that is.
They built a yurt, and then at one point, they built a second yurt and hired a guy so they'd have help up there.
I've seen it.